Hi, this is Kalpesh Sadasya. Today we are going to learn memory cache in ASP.NET Core. Why we use the some kind of caching is used for the performance and scaling point of view. So we are going to check how to utilize in our application. So let's start with the ASP.NET Core web application. I have created one default applications. So there will be a controller, model and view. So let's start with this configuration. For the memory configuration, it's very simple and easy. We just need to add the services dot add memory cache. One thing you notice it, we have added the before the add MVC services. So please keep in mind whenever you use the memory cache, please add before the add MVC services. Okay, so it's keep simple. So now we are ready, our configuration is done. Now we are ready to use it. So let's move to controller and we can define the private memory cache. This variable, this is the cache. Okay, now going to inject at home controller in constructor. Okay, so once we assign that variable cache equal to cache, now memory cache interface is injecting to our home controller and now we are ready to use the underscore cache variable. So let's make it one simple JSON response method. So public JSON response get all customers. Here we are going to define our methods where customers equal to new list of customer view model. I have created one customer view model that have only the two fields, one is the ID and one is the name. So once we define the variable customer, we are going to add customer information, customer view model ID equal to 1 and name equal to Kalpesh, and we are going to return the customers. Okay, now we are just done. It's getting the error. Okay, yes, make sure here is the JSON written. Now press F5. Okay, it's running the application. Okay, the application is running. So we have created the /get all customers. Once you hit that, you will see the JSON output. I'm going to stop it and add one more customer. And two numbers, hit F5 and I'm refreshing the same page again. Okay, here we see the two JSON object. So simply think about that, I have created the one static list. Instead of we think about it, we are going to call the database and we'll get the record from the customer table. Okay, so I don't want to call every time my database, so let's create the one private method which will show that customer list of customers object all customers. Okay, and I'm just cut from here and past existing customers. Okay, cool. Now we require this variable over here as well. Okay, now we are writing the cache dot try. Okay, cache dot try. Then this, like if we'll check that if it is first time, then we're getting the customer equal to null, then we need to reinitialize it. So just copy the above, and if we get it, then we cache it again, cache set customer list. Okay, so now you see that I have first checked the make sure that you can give the one unique key with the whenever you cache it. You have just required the unique key, whatever the unique key you set it, the same unique key is required for the get purpose. Okay, here is the I'm first checking that if it is this key with any object, if it is not found or null, then we getting over here all customers. Okay, then stored into the customer cache key, customer list cache key. So we'll see running that. Once we hit that, okay now refresh it, and we can see that the customer is initialized and the first time is no cache, so it's taking from the all customers. Okay, and set it and response is result. Okay, now I'm refreshing again, so you see that it's taking directly out and with the all two counts. So that means like whenever the next time is coming there, that time it's not hitting to our database, so it's save the memory and avoiding to the multiple hits to our server or APIs. Okay, this is the basic example. Now we can add the timer, some kind of timer, how much time we need to add, cache is there. So let's add some configuration for the there are two type of caching options. One is the sliding and one is the set absolute sliding. So sliding, that means whenever the cache key is accessed, then it is added some time, so it is add to next 3 seconds. So once I'm going to access it again, it is it's window seconds. So this is the just like where the our application based on the our business requirement, how much time we need to cache such kind of data. So that will be a very useful. So let's refresh it. Now check our first time, so it is going inside. Now I'm going to refresh it again, it is calm. You can see that because within a 10 seconds, so it expired, no, session is not expired. So the overview of this memory cache is that it is used for the avoiding the multiple hits to the server and those kind of information that should not change, or we can say the change once in a while. So such kind of information we can store in a memory cache and giving the performance to the application. Thank you for watching. Subscribe my channel and comment below. Thank you.